the Republican nominee has a massive disadvantage. And especially when you have the leaders not putting their weight behind the people.
By that, Donald Trump means House Speaker Paul Ryan, who Trump said owed him a post-debate attaboy phone call.
So, you know, you'd think that they'd say, great going, Don. Let's go. Let's beat this crook. There's a whole sinister deal going on.
While Trump fights with Ryan, he continues to draw massive crowds, like at this mid-afternoon rally in Florida.
In 27 days, we're going to win Florida.
And Trump donors, for the most part, remain loyal. Trump raised $5.3 million at two fundraisers Tuesday in Texas, with half the attendees women, according to those familiar with the events. That's after this 2005 videotape emerged with Trump's sexually aggressive language about coming on to women. But now there's this. Tasha Dixon, a Miss USA contestant in 2001, said Trump, who owned the pageant, visited the main dressing room while she and other women were getting ready for a rehearsal.
He just came strolling right in. There was no second to put a robe on or any sort of clothing or anything. Some girls were topless, other girls were naked.
Dixon described the situation as unnerving.
Who do you complain to? He owns the pageant.
Trump appeared to confirm the intrusions in this 2005 interview with radio personality Howard Stern.
You know, they're standing there with no clothes. And you see these incredible looking women. And so I sort of get away with things like that.
Even so, Trump's campaign.